My guest is Nick Stavrou, and Nick is a soccer legend in Dallas-Fort Worth. Right now, coach of the Fort Worth Vaqueros, also a longtime player and assistant coach for the Dallas Sidekicks. Let's start with the Vaqueros, Nick. This Thursday, you guys do your annual sponsor jersey lottery, and that always kind of tells you that the season is right around the corner. What are you excited about building off last year's success?
Yeah, always, you know, obviously been involved for 2 years is my third year, and hopefully we've got better each year, and the goal is to do that again this year. Been a little bit tougher the pre-season this year because obviously several of our players are still playing with the Dallas Sidekicks as they finish up their season. So, you know, been giving me a little bit more time to work individually with some of the others to get them together, and then looking forward over the next few weeks to gel them all together, and hopefully they come together. So far, you know, we've already had one scrimmage and the boys look good, so excited. And of course, as you said, this Thursday really sort of is the first thing on the agenda to get the season rolling.
Last year, of course, the Fort Worth Weekly won the lottery. All the Vaqueros sponsors go in, and whoever wins it gets to have their logo on the Vaqueros jersey. That's not the only soccer team Nick is involved with this week, though. You played for many years for the Dallas Sidekicks, and Saturday, they're going to retire his number at their game. What does that mean to you?
Oh, it means everything to me. I mean, every minute of my professional career, I play for the Dallas Sidekicks. So, you know, obviously the loyalty from me is there, the memories are there, and, you know, to be honored like that is, you know, beyond my dreams.
And Nick started with the Sidekicks right out of Cleveland State back in 1991. Are there things that you learned in those early days with the Sidekicks that you now bring to these young players you're working with the Vaqueros?
For sure. You know, a little bit of the story. I was supposed to stay in Cleveland and play for the Cleveland professional team there. And so it was a little, you know, I'd already started being around those guys and you know, was getting set to be able to play with them before I was drafted to come down to Dallas. And it definitely was a blessing in disguise coming down and playing with the Sidekicks, you know, under Coach Jago, and then, you know, the veterans that were there, the Tattoos, the Kevin Smiths, and players like that. I mean, you know, for me to learn, you know, the trade of the indoor game, which is different, was great. And obviously, I mean, to learn from them both on the field and off the field, you know, they shaped me as a coach, as a person, and as a player as well.
Well, and the Vaqueros, you're going to get, I mean, the nature of it, they want a lot of young players coming in. I imagine that's got to help with you being able to work with them in these really formative stages.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, again, that's where I learned my my trade, and obviously I try and impart that onto the new young players coming now. And obviously I have a background in youth coaching, as I've been doing that for the last 25 years in North Texas. And, you know, so there are some of those players involved, but that's helped shape me, you know, in order to be able to teach the younger players that, you know, obviously the intricacies of the game.
Well, and for young players who are into the sport of soccer, it has changed immeasurably since you started here. In 1991, there was no FC Dallas. There was no Fort Worth Vaqueros. I'm sure youth soccer has changed. What are the key evolution things that you've seen over those years?
Yeah, and I think there's lots of things that have happened, and some good, some not so good, you know. But I mean, again, yeah, in 91 there was, you know, the MLS had not started, the World Cup hadn't been around as well before then, so there's a lots of things that have changed. I think that, you know, now you look at, you know, how many years further on, you know, you've got kids now of people that grew up playing soccer, which makes a big difference with regards to them being involved in soccer and their knowledge, not only from the coach, but from their parents as well, which is something that you have, you know, around the world with, you know, soccer being the world's game. I also think one of the biggest evolutions is now the amount of soccer you can go see. Obviously, you can go see the professional teams, whether it's indoor or outdoor. You can also see it on TV as well. And I think the kids learn a lot through watching. Obviously, the same thing happens with the other major sports in the US, and I think that that's been a more new evolution with soccer as well, to help bring the game further up.
And certainly, yeah, we see that everywhere, and certainly I'll be watching soccer this week on TV, which I would never have been able to do in 1991, except for maybe a Sidekicks game,
yeah,
occasionally.
Yeah, if you're lucky, yeah.
If I was lucky. Well, from Worthing, England to Fort Worth, Texas, Nick Stavrou, thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much.
For Nick Stavrou in the Fort Worth Weekly, I'm Rush Olson.